All right, so I just watched this season 11 of XBW, not season 11, the 2021 season of XBW. I got a lot to say. So,
in the town where I was raised,
let's get my review.
The clock ticks and the cattle graze. Time passed with amazing grace back where I come from. Now you can lie on a riverbank, or paint your name on a water tank, or miscount all the beers you drank back where I come from.
So, I'm going to start off with some pros and then some cons. Actually, I'm going to start with the cons. I'll start with the pros first because there were a couple things I liked about this. First off, the trailers seemed to be pretty good. They gave you the sense of like how awesome the headquarters was and all that stuff. Can't really think of the word, but the aura of the head of the being the headquarters and the good music choice and everything. Another thing I really enjoyed about this was Haji, the way he used Haji to find looking for Haji, he was nowhere to be found. And then at the end, he shows up. Probably one of the best segments in the whole season was whenever Chris was going looking for Food City or something, and then he was in his car, and then you heard some like the real American music start playing, which is a Hodgeemania trademark. And then the Am I Done Yet, where it showed segments when it was with me back in 2007.
What the crap? What's going on here? Good Lord in heaven.
So what? I am a superstar. You know what? Get my freaking music. Hold your lips, my
face. So it just showed a few of those while he was going to watch like Roseanne or something like that, whatever. But that was well done. I got to give props to the way that you used Haji. All right, so on to the rest of the season. So I guess I'm not gonna talk too long because I don't want the video to go too long. But season starts off with there's a new character, Destiny D-Nasty. Kind of a dumb name, but whatever. The season starts off with that, interviewing her about where she's been, where she's from, all that stuff. Eventually mentions Chris Extreme, says she wants to kick his ass or whatever, and then it kind of goes from there. Then you got Chris going to talk to an investor.
Like, you're like a businessman, right? In a way, yeah.
Because Sally pulled out. So I remember, which was actually a good thing. I was actually good. XBW begins on a good note. And then there's a bunch of segments where AJ Bourne comes back. He's stalking Destiny. And stuff like that. They keep going back and forth about funding and stuff with the investor. I'm not going to get too much into it. If you want to watch the season, you can watch it. I'm just talking about some of the stuff that really hit me. One of the things that actually two of the things that pissed me off whenever it came time for the fight. So Chris Extreme was a, and he was a big name. We battled back and forth for years. We were tag team partners, we were creative control. We were, he kind of ran stuff. He defeated Tyler Jett in one of the biggest XBW moments ever.
I fuck him off!
And then to see him going back and start training and just his run, the training montage was just so pathetic for him. He was running on a treadmill and sandals. He couldn't pick up like a 30-pound weight or something. But fell off the rowing machine. He was jumping up and down on this little trampoline. He couldn't use the balance ball. So it was just, it made her look a lot better, even though she's supposed to be this Ronda Rousey loving chick and everything, but it made her look a lot better. But it made him, like, it kind of hurt his legacy a little bit, in my opinion. Because he just looked pathetic. And moving on to the match, that doesn't help him too much either. Because he got a few good things of offense in, but he was getting his ass kicked pretty much the entire time. He got dunked in, like, two or three things of freaking water. He had the scorpion deathlock on her once, and then she used the plastic pumpkin and knocked it off. So, maybe it's time for him just to realize that there shouldn't be any more seasons of XW after this. That kind of ruined what we did in 2020. So maybe we shouldn't do anymore. That's kind of where I'm at with this. It should be done. He obviously doesn't have what it takes anymore. He got his ass kicked by a new wrestler who didn't really look that intimidating in the first place. She's basically a little twig. So, yeah, hopefully he learned his lesson, and even though he said he's going to tag team with her at the end of that, and then of course, like, you know, Hodge does come back, so maybe, I don't know. I don't know if it's over here or not, but he just doesn't have what it takes anymore. He's need to face facts that we're old now. We can't do what we used to do. As soon as you start realizing that, the easier this retirement thing is going to be for you.